Industrial democracy is most important concept in democratic countries. In industries also, there should be a democracy. That is called workers' participation in management. Here we try to empower workers and ensure that they participate in management. In industries, there are three constituents, namely employers, workers and employees and trade unions. These three parties can sit together for settlement of industrial disputes. There may be grievances amongst workers which may turn into industrial dispute. For that settlement also, this scheme will be useful. On the other hand, at every stage of decision making, if there is involvement of all constituents, then in that case, quick decisions can be taken without inviting arrogance of workers. We wish to empower workers as individuals who will have responsibility, and that will help in achieving the organizational goals. In that case, we develop and create a culture which will encourage all people to participate in the decision making process. That is workers' empowerment and the popular title is industrial democracy, which means that workers, employers, trade unions, they all participate, and workers work as partners of an enterprise, and they are allowed to participate in the decision making process. In fact, workers are given the right of self-expression, and they have an opportunity to communicate their views on framing the policies of the company. This means that workers have the freedom to participate at different levels of management. Now here workers and managers, these are two groups. Managers perform managerial functions, whereas workers have to perform their own work. In other words, they are accountable to their own work. No doubt managers occupy managerial positions and subordinates implement those decisions. However, accountability is with the managers only. On the other hand, workers are accountable only for their own work. If we talk about definition of workers' participation in management, well, we divide these words, workers' participation and management. Workers are those persons who are working in the industry and they are directly connected with production. Participation means involvement and management means to get things done. Here workers associate themselves for getting the work done. Now here participation has been defined as sharing of power and status between managers and the workers. The workers' participation will bridge the gap and workers will participate in the managerial process. Therefore, workers' participation in management means giving scope for workers to influence the managerial decision-making process at different levels by various forms in the organization. In other words, there is an involvement of workers in the decision-making process. And all these workers may be associated at different levels. The levels means that either it may be a top level of management, middle level of management, or the lowest level of management. These are the three levels on which they may be associated. Now, in what form they will be associated is a different matter. However, there is a possibility of associating workers at the top level or at the middle level of management or at the lowest level of management. For example, banking industry. In almost all nationalized public sector banks, at top level, there is a workers' participation in management. In other words, employees may nominate one person for the position of director of the nationalized bank. Hence, at top level, there is workers' participation in management. Why we should implement this scheme? Now, objectives express the need for this concept. If we introduce workers' participation in management in any form, either at the top level or at the middle level, or at the lowest level, well, we want to achieve these objectives. If this scheme is introduced, then we are likely to achieve these objectives. For example, increasing productivity. Now, if workers participate, they also involve themselves in the decision-making process, then productivity will be increasing. Everyone will be motivated to work more and more. actually we give them a better understanding of their role. They must be empowered, they must know what is their role in the organization. They will feel that they have been given some responsibility. Now when workers are allowed for self-expression and workers can give suggestions, well, that will certainly empower them to work more and more. Workers' participation has the objective to achieve industrial peace and maintain better relations and increase cooperation, which can be sought through workers' participation in management. Because in fact, all these workers, representatives of employers, will work together, and on the basis of that work, then they will certainly ensure industrial peace. Now, when they are given power to work, well, they will develop their own personality, and indirectly, we develop leaders from within the industry. Therefore, these are the objectives of workers' participation in management. Now, this may be, as I told you, that it may be a top management or middle management or lowest management. Now, this may be in ascending order or descending order. In other words, from the lowest level, workers may go for decision making at the higher level. And elected representatives may work on the joint council or board of directors, as I told you, banking industry. There you can have such participation. Or it may be in the descending participation, that from the top level they are delegated duties and they take decision making from the top level to the bottom level. That may be a possibility of ensuring participation. Now, what shall be the nature of participation? Now, it may be any form which the organization decides. In banking industry, if a worker is allowed to work as director, well, that representative will participate in meetings of the board of directors. So that is a top level participation. On the other hand, we may simply restrict to information sharing. That information is given to them and they may involve workers in the decision making process, or there may be a joint decision making. In other words, that workers and representatives of employers, both of them sit together and take a joint decision. On the other hand, it is also possible that we give them full-fledged power to take a decision with their own self-control exercised by them. When we say that there should be a participation, then in the Indian context, there are different modes of participation. And the first one is the Works Committee. Works Committee is a result of Industrial Disputes Act. Under the Industrial Disputes Act, actually, a Works Committee is constituted where there will be equal number of representatives from workers training, discipline are all discussed in the meeting of the first committee. In fact, first committees have not been successful in India. And it is because of the fact that it is a legislative mandate under the Industrial Disputes Act that companies must constitute a works committee. Whenever you impose decision from above, then implementation will be difficult. However, if we have participation and on the basis of suggestions, then we take a decision. Well, that decision may go a long way. However, works committees are on papers and not many companies have such participation. The another form or mode of participation is the Joint Management Council. Actually, we have inherited this system of Joint Management Council from Britain. In fact, all our labor legislations are from British India period, and we have adopted a similar situation. Now here there is a Joint Management Council, in other words workers and representatives of employers, both of them jointly represent on a council, and matters of mutual interest are discussed, and both the parties, they try to discuss problems of labor welfare, safety measure, grievance redressal, training, working hours, bonus, or decision making at any level. In other words, workers' participation in management is implemented through a joint management council. In every company, we set up a joint management council, and on that basis, representatives sit together at frequent intervals and they discuss and implement those problems, they find solution. Another form of participation is collective bargaining. Now, collective bargaining again is a negotiation process where representatives of workers, representatives of employers, they will sit together and discuss matters of mutual interest. Therefore, in collective bargaining, again, the same grievances or industrial disputes will be put up for negotiation, for discussion. And workers will be allowed to participate, because in collective bargaining also, workers, representatives will be allowed to participate. Therefore, jointly they discuss these matters, and after negotiating, a labor agreement may be arrived at. Another form may be co-partnership. The scheme of ESOPs, or we allot shares to workers, and workers work as a co-partner, and as shareholders they attend annual general meeting, as shareholders they exercise their voting rights, and whatever dividend is declared, they take the benefit of that dividend also. And another form is worker director, which I talked about. An example of banking industry has been given, where a worker director is appointed. In banks we do not have workers, but in banks we have employees. Employees are those persons who are not directly concerned with the production process. Therefore, in banks it is a service industry, therefore the employees representative in place of workers, employees representatives, they are are given a seat on the board of directors. And this scheme is very popular in Britain, in USA, and we have adopted this scheme, and only in the nationalized banks we have such a scheme. Now, in India, when we talk about this scheme, when works committees are working, and as I told you, under the Industrial Disputes Act of 1947, wherever you have 100 or more workers, when in that case a works committee is appointed. The function of a works committee is actually to preserve amity between the parties to industrial relations. In other words, they will discuss at works committee conditions of work. Basically, all conditions of work, may be working conditions, may be facilities, may be labor welfare, amenities, or for example ventilation, lighting, temperature near the plant, sanitation, facilities or amenities like drinking water, canteen, dining rooms, crèches, restrooms, medical and health services, safety, accident prevention, occupational diseases, protective equipment, adjustment of festivals and national holidays, administration of welfare funds, all these facilities, and in addition to it, whatever may be type of dispute, that industrial dispute will be settled by discussion at the works committee. Now, many other examples have been given, like say educational and recreational activities, library, even say facilities for workers like dispensary for workers or games, schools for children. Most of the townships we find that they have developed all such schemes. I will give you an example of JK Cements at Nimbahera, where they have complete township and they have school also for children. Now, regarding these facilities, workers are associated with the management of such facilities, and as works committee they can discuss all these points. Now, the first labor commission in independent India was National Commission on Labor, that is popularly known as P.V. Gajendra Gadkar Committee, and that was first National Commission on Labor. In 1969, it gave various recommendations, and here it was recommended that the functions of the works committees should be broad-based, should be expanded, and there should be a wholehearted implementation of recommendations of the work committee. In fact, works committees are on papers, because faithfully their recommendations are not implemented. That is why NCL has recommended that employers, trade unions, workers, all of them should see that all recommendations of works committees are implemented in a proper manner. Now, another form in India is of joint management council, where JMC is constituted by employers and JMCs are set up in companies where there are 500 or more workers. And in those companies, it has been recommended that there is a fair record of industrial peace. Where already they enjoy industrial peace, in those cases a joint management council may be constituted so that they discuss matters for the growth of that particular industry. Now employers, workers, trade unions, all of them, they participate and they have the only objective to ensure growth of that industry. Now it may be a private sector company or it may be a public sector company. There should be unions which may have affiliation with central unions like Inter and ATAC, and all of them sit together and work to take decisions about problems of workers like retrenchment, closure, reduction of work, or say operation has been stopped. Well, the council will discuss all these matters and they will take a joint decision. They may discuss matters relating to profitability, how organization is working, what is the profitability, profit or loss, or balance sheet can be discussed, long term plans of expansion of that industry, diversification, redevelopment. All these matters are the jurisdiction of Joint Management Council. Now the council may be given or assigned administrative responsibilities. Now administrative responsibility at the lower level of management, at lower level of management there may be welfare facilities, supervision of safety measures, vocational training and apprenticeship scheme. At lower level there may be preparation of schedule of working hours or payment of rewards or all matters relating to wages, bonus or collective bargaining. All these matters including individual grievances, these may be discussed and workers may be empowered to take decisions about these matters. Now so far as worker directors are concerned, they are part of the decision making at the highest level, and you can see say in public sector like Hindustan Aeronauticals Limited, which has number of units in India, and another say nationalized banks, where such scheme can be implemented. There may be shop councils or at the plant level. This was long back envisaged in 20 point program given during the period of emergency, where they wanted to improve production, productivity, efficiency, and for that purpose actually shop councils were also constituted by way of workers' participation in management. And the idea was that at shop level they should discuss matters regarding facilities, physical conditions, welfare, health measures, safety measures, or absenteeism if workers generally abstain from work on a holiday basis. Well, that absenteeism also was a matter to be discussed. Now this scheme is very good provided it is religiously implemented. The main point is that any scheme under legislation may not work, but on a voluntary basis if such a scheme is given, well, in that case such a scheme may be successful. Now if we really want that workers' participation in management should be successful, now for that purpose we will have to bring about a change in the attitude of management. In other words, attitude of management has to be changed, or they have a progressive thinking where they say that workers can take part in decision making and freely they can discuss all these problems. On the other hand, the prerequisite for success of workers' participation in management is that there should be a strong trade union. Strong trade union means that there should be a provision for a representative trade union. Unfortunately, in India there is no such provision. In the Trade Unions Act of 1926, there is no provision for a representative trade union. How would you elect a representative trade union? Now there are many central organizations like INTERC, ATERC, HMS, BMS, and number of other trade unions are there, and at every industrial area there is multiplicity of trade unions, there is a rivalry of trade unions, and therefore there is no provision in India to recognize a particular trade union which will represent all workers in a company, and they will participate in all such deliberations. And that is why all such schemes have miserably failed, and there is no strong trade unionism that way where there is a provision for a recognized trade union. Now here, if by mutual consent, negotiation, if other trade unions are also allowed, for example, we take one representative each from four unions working in that industrial area, well, all those four unions will participate with management. But management has to realize this, that since there is no provision for a representative or a recognized trade union, therefore some viability has to be found out, so that they have trust, faith, confidence, and they actually discuss and implement that scheme. The idea is that there should be a congenial, cordial labor management relation, and for successful participation, actually all those representatives who are participating should be given a proper training, and with that training of negotiation, participation, manners, etiquettes, all these points are to be explained to workers. And as a suggestion, the selection or election of a representative trade union must be given. Government of India has to find out means to elect a representative trade union for all types of negotiations, for all types of participation. Otherwise, which union will represent or participate as a representative trade union? Therefore, one has to see that Government of India should make out a provision for election of such trade union, so that whenever there is a matter of dispute, they discuss. The second suggestion is that since workers are not highly educated, at plant level there is a lower level of management, and lower level are given, well, on whose facilities the administration or the decision making process is given to workers. For example, a school. Now, management of a school. Well, at the lowest level of management, well, workers can be associated. Or say there is a dispensary. Now that dispensary, small dispensary, is used by almost all workers, their families. They have keen interest in that dispensary. Well, the decision making by workers themselves will help canteens. Say even at university level, at SPSU, the menu is decided by students. Well, accordingly, such facilities may be given to workers, and decision making power is also given to workers. That will ensure a proper form of workers' participation in management. Otherwise, these schemes will remain on papers and there will be no proper implementation. Therefore, it is necessary that workers get full empowerment. They are given actual decision making. Say, organizing games. Now, workers may be given a free hand. Okay, you organize matches, you organize games, or you organize all cultural programs. The idea is that they should be busy with some work, because vacant mind is devil's workshop. Therefore, workers should be busy and involve them in decision making at every stage. That will actually help them to implement a scheme. Therefore, the scheme of workers' participation in management, which we have borrowed from Great Britain, well, we can Indianize it. Indianization of that scheme is very important. And for that purpose, we can start with the lowest level of management, where we actually ensure participation. Or we can give a chance to educated workers to work as directors of the company at the top level. So that is another possibility where this scheme can be successful. The scheme is good. The spirit behind implementation of this scheme is also good, provided religiously these schemes are implemented for the betterment of the entire organization.